Hi guys, what's up? It's Izzy. Welcome to or welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video, as you can tell by the title, is going to be what clothes to bring to college. So I did this video last year and you guys loved it. I am currently going to be a junior at the University of Illinois. I am in a sorority, Kappa Delta. I just thought I would share with you what clothes I personally think you should bring to college. I think this would be helpful for incoming freshmen. Obviously, this is all my own opinion, so it really depends on your personal style and of course your school. I'm basing this off of what I typically wear and kind of the vibe of my school. So take this with a grain of salt. If you want to wear whatever you want, go ahead. But I just thought I would give you guys some ideas. Also, I thought I would remake this video from last year because the school situation with Corona is going to be a little bit different. So I thought I would modify some of the clothing items and more focus on loungewear for this video because I know a lot of people have online classes. So I have a lot of different clothing items to show you, and I made a list on my phone which I'm just gonna go through, and I hope this video helps you guys. Okay, first of all, I'm just gonna say in general, less is more when packing for college. I know my freshman year I brought like literally my whole entire wardrobe, and that is definitely not necessary. You don't need all your clothes at college, and I'm gonna get into that a little bit later of stuff you definitely don't need to bring. But I would say when you're packing, only pack the things you know you're absolutely gonna wear, and then some things of course you can pack like, oh, just in case, but really just pack your everyday basics and things that you find yourself pulling from your closet a lot. I kind of broke this into categories. So the first category is going to be like everyday, going to class, hanging out in your dorm, walking around campus type outfits. So me personally, I typically like to be comfortable when I'm in class, in my dorm, or in my sorority house. So I like to wear loungewear a lot. If you like to dress up for class, definitely do that. But the clothes I'm going to be showing you right now are more comfy, relaxed kind of loungewear clothes. But if you love wearing jeans to class, go for it. You probably look way better than I do. So as of right now, I have 3 classes still in person and 3 classes online. So I'm definitely going to be spending a lot more time in my room than normal. So a lot of these outfits are just for lounging around my sorority house, but they would still be super cute wearing to class. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is bottoms. So I live in Illinois. Like I said, I go to U of I and it does get cold. So definitely pack according to the climate of the school you're going to. But for the warmer months, I love wearing lounge shorts. These are a pair that I just picked up from Princess Polly. These are so comfortable, so it's literally like you're wearing pajamas, but they look so cute on. So it's like you tried with your outfit, but you're still super comfy. I love little shorts like this. Going along with that, another pair of lounge shorts are these sweat shorts. These are from Urban, and they are just Champion white sweatpants shorts. I've been seeing sweatpants shorts or sweat shorts, whatever you call them, all over Instagram and Pinterest. These are so trendy and cute. They just have the little Champion logo. And what I love about these shorts is that they're not super short, so I still would feel comfortable wearing these around campus. And then lastly, for like lounge shorts, I love biker shorts. These are just from Aerie, and not everyone likes biker shorts. They're definitely like a hit or miss, but I love wearing biker shorts. They're basically just leggings for the summertime. So I like wearing these with crop tops, a long t-shirt. I think these are just so nice. Then as it transitions into the colder months, obviously you're gonna want to start wearing pants. So I would recommend bringing some leggings. These are just from Lululemon. I love Lulu leggings. And then I also have a pair from Fabletics. I love their leggings as well. These are a fun camo print, and then these are just navy. I would recommend bringing a lot of leggings, especially if you work out in leggings and then wear them to class as well. You're going to be going through a lot of different pairs. In the wintertime, these are great to wear with sweatshirts, sweaters. Then when you're feeling really comfy, I would recommend bringing some joggers. I lived in joggers last year. I wear joggers all the time during the fall and winter. These are from Brandy. They have my favorite joggers, but I know Aerie has some really good ones. I got some from Lounge recently that I love. I would recommend bringing cute joggers that still look like you're presentable. They're super comfy. I would recommend bringing a lot of basics to pair with your bottoms, and you can mix and match all of the tops for wearing to class or lounging. This is one of my favorite t-shirts. It's kind of hard to tell because the print is pretty faint, but this says Kappa Delta, which is my sorority. It's just a loose, comfy cotton tee. I love wearing this, especially with biker shorts. I think it looks so cute. And then a different kind of t-shirt I could recommend is like a tight-fitted crop tee like this. This is so versatile for wearing to class with joggers, or you could wear this out with some fun jewelry and jeans. This is really nice. This is from Target, and I believe it was like $4. This also is like an elevated basic, so it's this tan-colored t-shirt from Princess Polly. It has a rib material, so it's a little bit more something something. And I absolutely love the beige color. I feel like wearing this color makes you look like you really know what you're doing. I don't know, I feel like something about wearing neutrals and pairing neutrals with denim or neutrals and other neutrals makes you look really put together. So I love t-shirts like that that are very versatile. I would recommend bringing items to school that you can mix and match for a lot of different occasions and a lot of different outfits. Going along with the basics, I would say to bring some basic kind of tank tops or crop tops. This one is from Zaful and I wear this all the time. Zaful is really good for affordable pieces. I would recommend picking up some plain tank tops like this in like white and black. You can mix and match this with joggers, leggings, gold jewelry, and it's a perfect outfit. Then if you go to school somewhere where it does get cold, I definitely recommend bringing layering pieces. So I lived in hoodies during the winter time, especially when it's just absolutely freezing. In the morning when I wake up, I would just throw on a hoodie and some leggings, call it a day. It's such an easy outfit. I recommend getting hoodies that are just basic and cute that you can pair with a lot of stuff. That's like the theme of this video. Make sure you can pair all your clothes with a lot of things. This one is from Lounge. It's just this beautiful lilac color and says Lounge down the front. I love this one. Here is another sweatshirt. This is just from Princess Polly. It's again like a nice neutral color that matches everything and it's cropped, so it makes you look a little bit more put together than just like a big baggy sweatshirt. As it transitions from summer to winter, I would recommend bringing some long sleeve t-shirts. These are great for layering under things, wearing on their own. Obviously you can pair these with jackets and they're just nice basics to have. This one's from Brandy Melville. It's a gray waffle shirt. I wore this a ton last year. Also something that I did a lot last year when I was feeling really lazy but still wanted to look cute for class is wear sweaters with leggings. I feel like wearing a sweater with leggings elevates your outfit so much and you feel like you're wearing a sweatshirt but you look so much more put together and cute. This one's from Princess Polly again and it has these cute little flare sleeve details and it's just a plain simple sweater. This with like a scarf and leggings or jewelry, so cute. I would also recommend obviously bringing jeans, jean shorts, if that's what you would typically wear to class. Like if you dressed up in high school and you want to dress up for class in college, you can bring nicer pieces like jeans as well. I would say personally, I did not wear jeans that often to class. I just wore leggings and loungewear, but I definitely wore a lot of jeans when going out, which I will talk about in a little bit. Okay, as for clothes that I would recommend you do not bring a ton of, first of all being t-shirts. So I'm talking about the t-shirts that you sleep in, the big baggy t-shirts you wear maybe to work out. Maybe only bring like 5 or 6 of them. This being because you will get so many free t-shirts your freshman year of college. So when you go like to quad day, sign up for clubs, sometimes you'll get a free t-shirt. Also, if you're planning on joining Greek life, you will get so many t-shirts from all the events. When you first get into the sorority, when you get your big, you will get so many just t-shirts that say your sororities. My t-shirt drawer at college was overflowing. I would also say not to bring a ton of casual dresses. So I did not really wear dresses to class at all. The only time I would wear a dress is for a formal event for my sorority, and that kind of dress is a lot different than a casual sundress. I rarely found myself wearing dresses, and I brought a bunch of dresses to school, so they just took up room in my closet. Obviously, if you live somewhere warm or go to school somewhere warm and your style is really girly and you wear dresses all the time, bring all your dresses. But I'm just saying for me personally, I typically don't dress up for class, so I didn't really have a need for casual dresses. Also, something that I would say not to bring a lot of is purses. I typically, during the school year, don't use my purse at all. During the summer, I will use my purse, or if I'm going out at night at home, I will use a purse, but at school, during the day, I just use my backpack. Everything I need, I throw in my backpack. And then if I'm going anywhere else, I'll typically put my stuff just like in my coat pocket. So I didn't really find the need for too many purses. I would say bring like 2 bags and that's all you need. Another thing I would say you do not need to bring to school unless you live somewhere super warm is swimsuits. So I brought a bunch of swimsuits to school. We have a pool in the campus gym right by my sorority house and I didn't swim in it once. So I have all these swimsuits. I was like, oh, I'll bring them for tanning. I never did that and I never swam. So if you go somewhere where it's cold, I would say maybe bring like 2 swimsuits just in case, but don't bring a bunch because you don't need them. Okay, now I'm gonna be moving into going out clothes. Obviously going out is not for everyone, so this doesn't apply to everyone, but this is just personally what I saw when I went out my freshman and sophomore year. So here are a few examples of some cute going out tops. This one is a strapless top that ties in a bow right here from Princess Polly. I wore this one a ton. This one's so cute. Wrap top tops are also super cute to pair with a little bralette underneath. It's also from Princess Polly. Literally like half my wardrobe is from Princess Polly, but it's just because they're so cute. So this is super nice for going out. And then this is also from Princess Polly, little tops like this with the kind of puppy sleeves I've been seeing all over the place, and they're so trendy. I would say if you're gonna be going out, bring the tops that you feel good in, but then also don't bring too many going out clothes, because chances are you will be sharing with your roommate, you'll be sharing with your hallmates. I shared clothes with all my roommates and all my friends all the time last year, so definitely bring a good amount of going out tops, but then there's always people you can borrow from. Something else you definitely need to bring to school are jeans. So I wore jeans every time I went out, pretty much. I just think investing in some good pairs of jeans that make you feel good is so important. Jeans are so versatile because you can wear them out, you can wear them to class, whenever. So here are some jeans from Princess Polly. These are more like daytime kind of jeans. They flare up at the end and they're light wash. I have also been seeing these jeans everywhere. These are Levi's jeans and they have the kind of button where it crosses in the front like this. These are really wide leg as well and they're frayed on the bottom. I feel like wide leg and straight leg jeans are really trendy right now. These jeans are from The Gap. They are a cigarette leg, so they're kind of like a skinnier straight leg jean. They're distressed a little bit. They have some rips and all my jeans are high waisted for the most part. These are super cute to wear out as well. These are a darker wash pair from Brandy Melville. I absolutely love these jeans. They just have little cuffs. And then I also would say definitely bring some black jeans. These are from Brandy Melville as well. They're wide leg black jeans. These are great for going out at night and pairing with crop tops and stuff like that. Another thing to keep in mind when going out is that there are going to be theme parties, especially when you're a freshman, you go to a lot of those. So some typical themes that I have seen are jungle theme. So definitely if you have animal print, bring that. I have this little bodysuit from Princess Polly that's snake print that I've worn before. This is so cute. Definitely bodysuits are really nice for going out as well. 80s is a really big theme. PJs is a really big theme. USA. You would be surprised at some of the themes that people come up with, but definitely bring some fun themed clothing if you think you're gonna participate in Greek life and going to theme parties. Also for going out, if you're joining any type of club, fraternity, sorority, whatever, you might have a formal or semi-formal event to go to. Here are some examples of formal dresses that I have worn. This one I sadly did not get to wear last year, but I might wear it this year. It is just this maroon ruched dress from Princess Polly. And then this dress I wore my freshman year. This is a red formal dress from Princess Polly as well. I would say bring maybe one or two formal dresses. And then of course, like I've said, you can borrow stuff from your roommates or your friends. Also, when going out, definitely have a pair of frat shoes and a frat jacket. So these are my frat shoes. I wore them out all last year. They are quite dirty. They're just my Air Force Ones. If you're going to frats or the bars, your shoes will get wrecked. I'm just telling you this right now. So definitely wear a pair of shoes you don't care about. I also, in the wintertime, wear my Doc Martens because if they get really dirty, I can just wipe them off. And then a frat jacket is essential for the wintertime. So a lot of times my friends and I would just go out in the winter in our crop tops and no jacket and just freeze and run to the bar or run to whatever party we were going to. But if you want to be smart and warm, wear a frat jacket over your cute outfit that you can just throw in the corner, throw in a closet or whatever. And if on the off chance it gets taken or lost, you won't care about it. So I have this really big kind of ratty denim jacket that I thrifted that I like to wear sometimes over my outfits if it's just going to be absolutely freezing outside. Okay, the next area I'm gonna talk about really quick is outfits to pack for game days or block or tailgating. So at my school, we do something called block, which is when there is a football game or really just any Saturday. Everyone goes out at like 10 a.m. on Saturday and we all wear cute kind of daytime darty attire, I would say. Here is an example of what I'm talking about. So here is just this Illinois sweatshirt that I cropped. I have worn this a bunch with some high-waisted jeans. I would say for darties or tailgating, bringing fun jeans, fun accessories, and you can DIY a lot of your school stuff. Like this I cropped. I would say looking for your schools in thrift stores is a really good and inexpensive thing to do, so you can customize and make them cute for game days and tailgating. Okay, the next area I'm gonna talk about really quick is shoes. So I would say not to bring too many shoes to college. You don't really wear that many. I would say bring one pair of sneakers that you could wear every day, like Converse, Air Force One, stuff like that. Of course, gym shoes, one pair of sandals, one pair of boots, and then I would say maybe one pair of heels, either black or nude so they match with everything. Of course, if you like to switch up your shoes a lot, bring more shoes, but I would say try to keep it to just the basic so you don't take up that much room. The last area I'm gonna talk about is accessories. So obviously accessorizing just elevates your outfit to the next level. Definitely bring a belt. I didn't have a belt freshman year and I was always borrowing my friends. I feel like belts just make your outfit so cute and I don't know why I never had one. This is my favorite belt from Brandy Melville. It just has these double kind of grommets on there. Also for accessories, definitely bring fun jewelry that you can wear for going out and layering. And then if you're going to school somewhere colder, I would definitely recommend bringing some jackets, like jean jacket, a fuzzy jacket, and then like a winter coat. Okay guys, I think that's everything that I wanted to talk about in this video. Obviously, I just talked about a ton of different clothes. Like I said in the beginning, take this with a grain of salt. This is just my opinion and personally what I found myself wearing a lot my past 2 years in school. I'm planning on making an entire video on what to wear for recruitment. So if you're planning on going through sorority recruitment, definitely subscribe to my channel and be on the lookout for that. I think that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah.